Hey guys, and welcome to Vlogmas Day 8. Starting the vlog off, what am I doing here? I'm sitting here waiting for Sebastian to add the ribbon to the tree. It's one of the last steps of what we have to do, and then I'm gonna add that footage to the vlog that goes up before this one. I decorated it last night by adding on all the ornaments, and originally I wanted to do something more like what I did with my artificial tree, having like really nice ribbon, but I went to Michael's to look for ribbon and they had almost nothing left. I'm gonna probably try to figure out something for next year to do more like extravagant ribbon, because I think ribbon just really makes the tree look so much more special and almost designer. Yeah, it was actually really sad when we went into Michael's. I think we went in on the 4th and the store was just completely empty. There was no Christmas stuff left. It was just totes and stuff for after Christmas around any holidays. So whether it's Halloween or Thanksgiving or Christmas, stores are already done with the event before the event actually happens. So it almost feels as if like it's already over, if that makes sense, because it doesn't feel festive in this store. It feels like everything's gone. When I was a kid, I remember like being at the stores just before Christmas and everything still felt like there was so much stuff. Nothing was put away. It wasn't all just totes for packing everything up. Makes me sad. But anyway, I feel like there should be a law that you're not allowed to do that. It really kills the Christmas spirit for me, especially this year where I'm not really feeling the Christmas spirit, mostly because I think it's gonna feel like a really empty and hollow Christmas. My family's probably not gonna be here, like 99% chance they're not gonna be here. I don't feel like I've accomplished the things I wanna accomplish with Christmas. I was talking about this with a friend the other day that I used to be very OCD about the holidays. I'm kind of like letting you guys into my weird mental health issue here, but I used to write down lists of things I needed to get done by Christmas, like a certain number of movies needed to be watched, a certain number of treats needed to be made, a certain number of baths needed to be had. I would be like, oh, I still have to use this bubble bar, I still have to use this bubble bar. All of my Christmas bath products I would want to use by Christmas. I wouldn't want to use them after Christmas. I would want to have like that experience before Christmas, and movies and stuff. I haven't watched any Christmas movies this year except for we started A Miracle on 34th Street the other day, and I've watched Hallmark Christmas movies kind of on in the background, and then The Holiday when we put up our tree, the first tree. And apart from that, I haven't done anything. It's weird, and I think that just not doing these things that makes it feel Christmassy to me is kind of killing my Christmas spirit this year or something. It makes me sad. I'm gonna try actively to get more into the Christmas spirit and do more festive things. Outside of that long ramble, my update for now is I have been working for the last little bit, couple hours, and I have some more work to do. I hope I can get it done quickly so then I can start working on the vlog that has to go up later. I definitely have a lot of work related stuff to get done today, and hopefully I can take care of a good portion of that. Ordinarily this time of year I take the whole month off just to do Vlogmas, which I appreciate that I have the flexibility to do that sometimes, but this year I'm still doing both. So if it seems like I'm extra strapped for time and doing less than I normally would, that might have something to do with it, because I'm trying to squeeze that in there as well as Vlogmas. I spend probably like 8 to 10 hours editing every single video, unless it's a shorter video and doesn't have that much content. You're eating gingerbread?
Yeah.
What kind? We haven't opened our advent calendars in 2 days. We have 3 to catch up on. So we have 6, 7, and 8 to catch up on. Do you guys enjoy the advent calendar parts where we compete to see who can get it first? Sebastian always says don't include it. He says like leave it out.
I don't think anyone wants to see me chase down the chocolate.
Us. It's us.
Well, look at that.
Herze.
Herzen. Oh, no.
No, is it Herzen or it's gem, a fruit filled, isn't it?
Yeah.
I could just tell by seeing it.
I don't like those.
I don't like anything covered in dark chocolate. Okay, I I look like a glazed donut right now because I have salicylic acid on my face. I haven't been using it for the past couple nights, so I just used some. Sebastian just went to go pick up our Christmas cards. They were actually supposed to be delivered yesterday and it was really annoying. They said they tried to deliver them, but they really didn't because we have a Ring doorbell, which would have notified us, and also no one called me. So I was really annoyed, but they're here now and he has, you haven't looked at them yet, right? Do you wanna bring them over so we can look at them together? All right, let's see. I'm so excited. Let's check out the envelopes first. Save the best for last. So it says deliver to and has our address in the back. So this is the envelope. Cute. And we have to send them out, I think by what, 3:30? So they actually get mailed today.
Oh, they're beautiful.
So this is what we got. Gold foil and it's raised. Do you feel it? So this is the front and then this is the back.
Oh, that's a different back.
Yeah. Wishing you and yours a wonderful holiday season. All the best in the coming year. Sebastian and Kristi-Anne. So now we know what this looks like. Maybe next year we will try a different printer and see who does it best. And it didn't take very long either. I ordered them on the 29th of November,
yeah,
and then they're here now. And they printed them and shipped them, so that's great. But I did get express shipping because I needed them ASAP. But yay, I'm so happy they're here now. Sebastian chose the picture for the front. He said that he wanted one to look like more funny. I personally liked this picture best, or like one of the ones where I was standing best, but ultimately he won. He won this one.
Have you seen my t-shirt yet?
Oh, you're wearing it! This was the sample. This was the test run of when I made the pillow for the DIY video. It's kind of crooked on there. I just wanted to test it out on like a crappy t-shirt first to see how it would work, to make sure that I had a good idea of how much pressure to add and stuff for the foil. But it's so pretty. It says, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. But if the white runs out, I'll drink the red. It's one of my favorite Christmas quotes. I think it's so funny. For like birthday cards and stuff or Christmas cards, I always buy the one that's really funny, and Sebastian always buys the one that like makes you cry. And I never want to make people cry. I always want to have like something that's like funny and laughable. He needs it to be very dramatic. Probably why you like Hallmark movies so much. Frequently cries in Hallmark movies. You can put that on your profile about me.
No,
frequently cries.
I get sad sometimes.
No, you cry.
Because every Hallmark movie starts with like half of my family is dead and now I'm looking for a new partner or something like that, you know?
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna continue editing. Hopefully in a couple minutes I'll be able to fix the tree. So this is what the tree's looking like. Sebastian added the ribbon and now I have to go in and stuff the ribbon underneath the ornaments and into the branches of it because otherwise it looks weird that it's like just sitting on top. So a little update. I got my video up. I've just been relaxing for a few minutes. Sebastian went to Walmart to grab the stuff that we need to make dinner. We're gonna make dinner in a minute, but I'm actually not even really hungry. I'm kind of glad though, because I was starving earlier and I thought there's no way I'm gonna be able to make dinner with how hungry I am right now. And then I remembered that we grilled a bunch of chicken the other day. So I had some chicken with some barbecue sauce. And outside of that, all I've eaten today is candy. For the past several days, from the moment I wake up, I crave it, but I've just been browsing the internet for some gifts. I have been looking for stuff for Sebastian. One of my traditions every year, and I'm really sad this is not gonna happen this year, but one of my traditions every year is to buy him a ton of stuff from Abercrombie. It's like, I love the sweaters. They have such cute stuff for guys, and it's always usually really fitted and nice, and the quality is really great, and they always have a really great sale for Black Friday that's like 40% off. So you really cannot beat it, and it used to be 50% off. Then this year it was 30% off, but every single thing for guys is now oversized. And you guys know Sebastian, he's tall, but he's kind of lanky. And I don't mean that like in a negative way or anything. I feel like it sounds like I'm judging him. I'm really not. I think he has such a nice like figure when he wears clothes. I'm always so jealous. I'm like, wow, you have like such nice proportions. So I'm not like insulting him at all. I'm just saying that this does not suit his type of figure. But I've been looking on the internet to try to find something that I can kind of replace the Abercrombie stuff with, and I just discovered J.Crew. They have very similar stuff to what I liked from Abercrombie, except they're like 5 times more expensive, maybe even more than that. They have really, really nice stuff. I'll show you guys. This is the stuff I'm looking at, but like the sweaters are just really nice shape. Obviously, I would not get like a cashmere sweater for Sebastian. He'd probably end up ruining it. But they do have really nice shaped sweaters. So they're more like fitted, stuff that Sebastian would actually wear. But they have like these cotton shirts that are really nice. also pretty pricey, but not that bad. I really like their Christmas sweaters. This gives me like the Santa Claus vibes. Do you guys remember Neil? He always wears sweaters like this, and they're made fun of in that franchise, but I think they're so cute and Christmassy, so I love those. I think this is really nice. I even like colors I would typically not like for instance this one I think is a really nice color, and then this one is super cute, so Christmassy, this Fair Isle print. I love it. It's just so beautiful. So I'm gonna go through here and see what I can find. There's a lot of cuts I really like. I really like this sweater as well. Like for instance, this one is even so cute, and it's like Christmassy merino wool. So it sounds like it's really nice quality. Oh my gosh. Okay, we already know I'm gonna get him this. There's just a million things. And like after that, I'm gonna go check and see what they have for girls, because I literally love all of this stuff. Like this is exactly the kind of stuff I would want to buy. I can't believe it took me this long to discover it. I don't typically like colorful things, but this is just so cute. It gives me like elf vibes or something. Oh my gosh, this sweater is so beautiful. I really hope I can find a coupon. This is also really cute. Oh my gosh, they have 4 pages. What am I gonna do? Okay, I'm gonna leave this open. I'm gonna do some shopping later. This is another concern I have. It says that in order to get it by Christmas, I have to order within the next 13 hours. So I'm gonna have to do some shopping later. So time to make dinner. By the way, in case you didn't understand what I was talking about earlier when I said I've been living off of candy, this is what I've been eating. It is the Sweet Tart ropes in, this one's tangy strawberries. Fashion just bought these. These are smaller than the ones I've been eating. I've probably gone through like 5 packages in the last 2 days. I'm straight up an addict now, so I need help. Find me in Sweet Tarts Anonymous soon.
Apparently it's very nutritious because you've been surviving. I hope it's not like this, what is it called, Twizzlers? Did you hear the story about the guy who ate the...
It was licorice.
Licorice Twizzlers. Oh, it was Twizzlers. He ate those for 4 weeks or so straight and died.
Of a heart attack, because real licorice, the kind that you like, the black licorice, has something in it that changes your heart rhythm.
Yeah, it's supposed to be something that you snack on from time to time. You're not supposed to buy something and eat it all the time, every day.
We're going to make something that I've been thinking about since fall. I've been wanting to make it since fall, and honestly the reason I didn't was because I was too lazy to peel and cut a butternut squash. What I want to do is I want to roast the butternut squash and roast it with either, did you buy shallots? You bought shallots, right? And some garlic. And I want to caramelize that in the oven. What I would also like to do is caramelize some onions on the stove so they get like nice and sweet. So then after the butternut squash is cooked, I want to add it to the blender with some pasta water. And then from there, add it to the caramelized onions and add in some heavy cream, reduce it, lots of Parmesan cheese. So now that's the whole process, and let's get into the montage.
Oh, really good.
Mmm.
Tastes delicious. Mm-hmm.
Wow, that is really good. The butternut squash and the caramelized onions are so sweet. And then there's like the nice saltiness, and the parsley is really nice. Mm-hmm. I thought it needed basil, but I think parsley was the right way to go.
I think basil would have been too strong.
The butternut squash is so sweet though.
What are the little like kind of crusty pieces in here?
Salt.
Caramelized, oh, it's salt, okay.
You mean the crunch?
Mm-hmm.
That's the salt, Meldon salt. That is good.
It's so good.
Mm. It's a good winter dish because it's pasta, obviously. But I think it's also a good fall dish because of the squash.
I was just
which is why I thought of
when
it.
When you said that, that it's actually also a good fall dish.
I'm like, I'm not hungry, but I want to eat the rest of this. So we're going to finish this and then we will catch up with you when we're done. So it's a little later. I'm going to wrap a couple gifts for my family. Sebastian and I are going to go to Whistler on Monday and we absolutely have to get a lot of stuff done before we go. So I figured I would wrap the things that I do have tonight. Hopefully I can make some progress on that. And then I still have so much gift shopping left to do, but I think that if I get this done, I will feel that I've done something at least. I have a few rolls of paper here. You already know how obsessed I am with wrapping paper. So I only pulled out a few of my rolls that are not my favorite because my family just really doesn't care about nice wrapping. I wish they did. The only time I do nice wrapping for them really is when they come to visit me because I like the visual appearance of the nice wrapping under the tree. But outside of that, I know that these packages are gonna be shipped. They're not gonna look cute. So I'm just gonna do some basic wrapping. So I'm not gonna do like a whole wrap with me video. I also wanna put on Love Harder. If you've not seen it, it's on Netflix. How many times have I seen it now?
I don't know, I think we watched it like at least 10 times.
Nina Dobrev is in it. For any of my OG viewers, you already know how much I love Nina Dobrev. It's just the cutest story. It feels very well produced. It doesn't feel like Hallmarky at all. It feels like a rom-com Christmas movie. It's really, really good. I really want them to get a lot of views on this movie so that they do either a sequel or Nina Dobrev gets more Christmas movies or any movies on Netflix because I love her so much. Anyway, I'm gonna get into the wrapping. I'm gonna start with this roll I got the other day from Target. And I love this paper because on the back side it has those grids, so it makes it really, really easy to cut. I'm gonna wrap this first. I sincerely hope my family's not watching because I do have some things that are not in boxes that when I wrap them, they'll be able to see what's in it. I apologize, this one was a little bit on the shorter side. I try to keep them on the longer side because you guys always ask me to make long vlogs for you guys. I was hoping to add extra stuff to the vlog for today, but today has been absolute chaos. It has been an emotional roller coaster, which I will talk about in the next vlog, which will hopefully go up tomorrow, but if it doesn't, it'll just be because today has been chaotic and there's been a complete change of events for what is gonna be happening for Christmas. Yeah, I will tell you guys about that in the next vlog. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, hit the subscribe button. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all for Vlogmas Day...
Nine.
For Vlogmas Day 9. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Christmas.